Hey growers, John from Horizon Hydroponics here, and today I want to talk about sizing dehumidifiers and air conditioners for your grow room. So when we're talking about air conditioners and dehumidifiers, we want to accurately size them. Too large or too small will create inefficiencies in operation. So first I want to talk about air conditioning. Every 1,000 watts of light is going to equal roughly 4,000 BTUs of heat when it comes to cooling capacity. So if we have 3,000 watts worth of light, we're going to want 12,000 BTUs equal to 1 ton of cooling capacity. So if I'm talking about cooling an 8-light room, 8,000 watts, that is going to be roughly 32,000 BTUs. And at 12,000 BTUs per ton, that's 2.75 tons of cooling that is needed. Since there's not a 2.75 ton air conditioner, we'll want to get a 3-ton air conditioning unit for that. Now, if we are including CO2 burners and other heating type equipment, we're going to want to include those in our BTU calculation. Some of the other factors when sizing your air conditioning are the hottest temperatures outside that you're going to see, as well as the coldest temperatures outside you're going to see. Some equipment cannot run in negative degrees. Some equipment is going to have a hard time keeping up with a 100 degree day outside and trying to keep your grow room even at an 80 degree temperature. All in all, when it comes to creating your environment, air conditioning with multiple lights is a necessity. You will need some sort of air conditioning to manage your garden. The second key piece of equipment in your environment, in your grow room, is your dehumidifier. And why is that? It's because of transpiration. Transpiration is when plants move water from their roots to their shoots, and then they dump it out into the environment. Plants do this all day long when the lights are on. So when it comes to sizing your dehumidifier, it's all about water in and water out. If you feed your plants every day, 5 gallons a day, convert the gallons to pints, that would be 40 pints. So you need at least a dehumidifier that can handle 40 pints of water every day. That way, as the plants transpire, the dehumidifier is able to absorb that much moisture. The other thing to take into consideration with your dehumidifier is when the lights go out. That first hour or so, the plants are still warm and they're still giving off quite a bit of moisture, but the air conditioners typically kick off. When the air conditioning is running, it also is absorbing a lot of moisture from the air. So when it kicks off at night, you lose a lot of dehumidification from that unit itself. So your dehumidifier needs to be able to kick in and cover some of that extra moisture that happens when the lights go off. Make sure you have plenty of dehumidification when the lights click off, because that's when powdery mildew is going to set in, and you want to keep the room as dry as possible. So growers, if you have any other questions on ACs or dehumidifiers, hit us up at horizonhydroponics.com, our Facebook, Instagram, or give us a call. And we'll see you next time.